Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's learn about bases that can and cannot be used to cleanly deprotonate ketones to make enolates. We have a 2x3 grid on the screen. This grid shows six acid conjugate base pairs with the pKa values of the acids. In the top left, we have a ketone, which is weakly acidic at the alpha carbon. It is our acid with a pKa close to 20. The conjugate base is the enolate. So if we want to deprotonate a ketone with an equilibrium that favors the enolate, we need to use a conjugate base of an acid that has a pKa higher than 20. Let's look at our options. Going across the top row to the right, we see water and sodium hydroxide as an acid conjugate base pair. The pKa of water is about 16, too low for sodium hydroxide to be a good base for making high concentrations of enolates. So this is too weak. The next pair in the top right corner is H2/NaH. We used sodium hydride to make alkoxides. Sodium hydride is protonated to form H2 gas with a pKa around 36. H2 has a nice high pKa, greater than 20, but sodium hydride reacts very slowly with ketones. So slow reaction. People don't use it much. On the bottom row, to the left, we have ammonia and sodium amide. NaNH2, sodium amide, is great for making acetylides. Since ammonia has a pKa of around 35 or so, sodium amide is plenty strong enough to make enolates. The problem is it is also nucleophilic and tends to attack the weakly electrophilic ketone. We need a base, not a nucleophile. Moving to the right, we have a new acid-base combination. The acid is diisopropylamine, and the base is lithium diisopropylamide, almost always called LDA for short. Diisopropylamine has a nice high pKa of about 35. LDA is a strong enough base. It also avoids being a nucleophile because of the steric bulk of those two isopropyl groups. This is a bulky base. It won't attack the ketone. LDA is the most common choice for deprotonating ketones to make an enolate. Finally, on the bottom right is butane as a super weak acid. pKa is 50. And butyl lithium, sometimes written just B-U-L-I. Butyl lithium is an organolithium. It's an incredibly strong base. But again, as we've seen in past videos, butyl lithium loves to attack carbonyls. Butyl lithium is a poor choice as a base because it is too nucleophilic. For that carbonyl. Okay, those are some of the common bases and how they fare for making ketones. LDA is the clear winner. Under the right conditions, we'll also be able to use bases like sodium hydroxide and the alkoxides. We'll see that butyl lithium is still important because we need a good base to make our LDA, and that will be in the next video.